इट्स ऑलमोस्ट टाइम अप. हेलो,
यस सर, वी
या
कैन,
वी कैन नो. ओके, सो लेटर
यस
ऑन द
सर,
पार्टिसिपेंट्स विल जॉइन. ओके, सो यस्टरडे आई वाज प्रैक्टिसिंग. विल कंटिन्यू विद दैट सेट, लोड बैलेंसिंग. ओके, हैव अ लुक ऑन दैट. यस्टरडे आई वाज प्रैक्टिसिंग दैट एंड इवन आई वाज एबल टू सक्सेसफुली आई वाज एबल टू एग्जीक्यूट दैट. सो दिस वाज माय, कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन? हेलो, व्हिच स्क्रीन यू कैन सी मैम?
सर, इट्स द पीपीटी राइट नाउ.
Okay, so now can you see my console?
Yeah, now it's
Yeah,
the console.
see, this was my server one. Okay, so this is the server one what I have created. Okay, and this is the image copy of that server one. I'll explain you how to create the image copy of that server one using IME. So now, okay, this both the servers are the interconnected with each other. So whatever the files I'm sharing from this server one, that can be you can access from image server two also. Understood. Now next, regarding about the load balancing, I'll show you. Then we will start designing such type of a model. Let's go to load balancing. So using the load balancing technique, okay, I have integrated both the servers. So after integrating both the servers, okay, so whatever the files are there in server one as well as the server two, both can be accessed. Okay, using load balancing technique. Hold on a second. So till then, hold on. So this is my load balancer. Can you see this, ma'am? Hello?
Yes, I can
Yeah,
see.
yeah. So this is the load balancer where my both the machines are attached. So click on this, hit on this one. Okay, so just this this DNS name is there, no? Just to copy this DNS name. Okay, and click here. Okay, paste here and run the load balancer. Can you see this pages? Now I'm able to see this page and the load, how many number of users are coming, the usage of based upon the users usage. Okay, so automatically I'm going to up and scale my the CPU as well as my data. Okay, the space over there. Similarly, we'll try to check other two servers. Let's say I'll go to EC2 now. Let's see whether the same page is available on my server one or not. Hit on server one, copy this IP address. This is the IP address of my server one, straight over here. So can you see the same page? Hello? Okay, so same page I
Yes,
can, yeah,
yes.
same page I can access from this server, the actual server. Similarly, I have the image copy. Let me go to image copy. Okay, so image copy, this is the IP address of my image copy of that same server. Let me run this also. Okay, so you can see the same page here. Hope you are clear. Okay, so same thing, this
Yes,
auto
sir.
balance, yeah, auto using auto balancing technique, I can bring all these two servers together and okay, I can so whatever the clients are requesting, I can access to through this load balancer. And load balancer will decide okay, how to migrate or where to migrate the user. So shall we start then? Okay, so let's have a hands-on
Yes.
session. First is yesterday while designing, I did some the mistake. That's the reason I was not able to access. Let's start with the new instance. This you know this how to create the instance very well.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Let me quickly try to cover this. Okay, I'll go to Ubuntu. Let's say Ubuntu. Okay, select Ubuntu. Next is configure T2. I will take the T2 since we are this is for training session. I'll go with the T2. Number of instance, I'll keep one. Number of instance. Okay, so here VPC everything is remain same. Next, add storage. Next, storage space is 8 GB. Next tag, let's say the tag B. This time I will create the server name B, server 2. Okay, don't get confused there. Already I have server 2. Sorry, server 1 I have. Server 2 I will create. Configure the security. Here I need one more SSH already I have. So I need HTTP. Okay, so that I can access my server. The what I can say Apache server. HTTP, I'll select HTTP, TCP, same thing, anywhere I'll type here. Fine. Okay, so next is review and launch the server. Review and launch the server. Okay. So next is launch this. So to launch, I will use the same existing key pair. Okay, bash 2 new. Next, launch instance. Launch instance. Next, new launch. New launch. Hold on. So that means I have one more new server here called server 2. Okay. So till then, let me show you. Okay, so these are two pages. That will take time. Okay, so hope you can see my the desktop now. Let me save. Oh yeah, desktop. I have created one simple two pages. So this is, let's say, index one. Okay, index one. This page is from server two. Let me modify this. Okay, I'll try to change this index.html with the. This page is from server 2, I will mention, because already, okay, so this page is from server 2. Okay, so this page is from server 2. This page is from server 2. Okay, let me change the title also, server 2. Save this. Similarly, I have, okay, I'll create one more here. Say server 1 I have mentioned. Let me assign this one as server 2. Okay, so let me change this one with server 2. So simple HTML pages I'm creating just to demonstrate, okay, how to maintain the load balance in using AWS. Okay, so server 2 I will mention here. This page is from server 2. Okay, server. So this page is from directory server 2. I'm going to create one directory over there. Fine. So two simple pages I have created. So I'm going to dump these two pages in my EC2 engine. Okay, so go to EC2. Hope this is up and running now. Hold on a second. So till then, I'll go to Putty. Okay, go to Putty. Select Putty. Next. Select this IP address. Select the IP address. Paste it. Key pair auth. Next. Choose the key pair. PPK file. Next. Open. Hold on. Hold on. Let me refresh this. Yeah, it's up and running now. Okay, so let me open this. Okay, hope you can see my screen now, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so Ubuntu. Oh my god, no support option. Hold on. Again. So which screen can you see now? Blank, I guess, right?
Yes, sir. Now it's blank.
Hold on. Now you can see Putty console, right?
It's loading. Yeah, I can see.
Okay. Fine. Auth. Next. Auth. Next. Batch 2. Okay, open it. Hello? Yeah. Ubuntu. So Let me configure this very quickly. I'll configure this. Clear app sudo apt-get apt-get update. So after that, let me try to install one Apache server here. Okay, next is sudo apt-get install Apache 2. Okay, open it. Fine. So next is, let me clear this. Let's see whether I'm able to access Apache server or not. I'll go to a main console. Okay, here let me put in 0.94.71. Let's see whether I'm able to access Apache now. Yeah, I'm able to access Apache now. Now what I will do, I'll try to replace this with my simple pages. Okay, just so that I can differentiate how load balancing is taking. Okay, so how we are configuring the load balancing. Okay, so next is, I'll open my WinZip. WinSCP. Okay, so in WinSCP, so here, let me, okay, yeah, let me open that, this server 2. Okay, so I'm going to open my server 2 now. So to open this, just copy this, go to host name of WinSCP, paste it over here, just to type Ubuntu. Okay, go to advanced auth. Okay, share the ppk with your batch 2. Next to open it, open, save this one. Okay, save this. Next to login. So that means now I'm in my, okay, freshly installed the Ubuntu server. Okay, hope you are clear, ma'am. This rough, okay, I'll try to finish this. Any doubt in this, ma'am? Hello?
No, sir, not yet.
Okay, so I'll again go to index. Just drag and drop those two pages, index.html and okay, server2.html. Okay, so I have dragged those two pages. Let me close this one. My job is almost, now I don't want WinSCP. Okay, so now let me check in on my console now. So, okay, whether those two files are available. Let's say ls, let me do ls. So I can see those two index.html and server2.html. Now I have to move these two files from this location to my var www.html, the file, understood? So here sudo, just type mv slash, this is the home directory, /ubuntu. Okay, and give the name of the file, index.html. Okay, so I'll mention html. Next, destination address is var /www/html. HTML. Okay, so here I have to paste. So that means I have forwarded one, the file over there. I have moved the file over there. Similarly, I'll try to move this file also. Let's see. Okay. Server2.html. Fine. So let me move this, put the file. So this is moved now. Let me go to that exact location now, var.www.html slash. Okay, sorry. No such file or directory. What HTML www.var.html, correct? No, HTML. var.html. Let me check it. Where sudo cd var dot www. Why it is happening like that? What mistake I'm doing here? Sudo cd var dot dot www slash. Yeah, let me ls. I have HTML, cd HTML. Okay, so here, can you see both the files are here now? Ma'am? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, file I have participated. Next, again, I'll go to, let me go to my console again. Let me refresh this. So, you can see index. Can you see? This page is from index. Okay, index.html. Let me try.
Yes.
Okay, slash server2.html. Okay, server2.html. So can you see both the pages are available here? Now one thing you can see is the index in it. See, have a look on this. Okay, so index.html in this IP address. Fine. Hello. Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Index is in this IP address. So at the moment. Okay. So when I say slash server2.html. Okay. So that means it is redirecting. See, my path is changing here. So what I will do now, I will create two servers. One is for index.html and another is one for server.html. Okay, so next, the people who are trying to access server.html, I will try to migrate those, the user to servers.html server. Sorry, server2. Okay, the people who are trying to access index.html, I'll try to migrate in other server. Hope you are cleared.
Yes, fine? Sir.
Okay, so that can be done using the auto balancing, load balancing system here. Okay, auto scaling system. So to do auto scaling, again, let's start with the EC. So generally what we do, we try to create the mirror copy of this. Okay, so remember. So first is what I have to do is server 2. Don't get confused. I have server 1 and server 2. This is the mirror copy of server 1. Now let's go to server 2 now. So the moment after clicking select server 2, next go to action. Go to images here. Okay, go to images, create the IAM image. So, mirror copy of that server. Okay, so server two, image, let's say image two I will give. Okay, image two I will give for that server. No, image one of server one. Server two, image one. Understood. Now next, create the image. Okay, so close it. Now you can see, so that effect you cannot see here on your EC2 instance, okay, or EC2 console. Suppose if you want to check all the images, so you have to go to images. Under images section, I have IAM image. Click on IAM image. Okay, so here, see, have a look on this. Okay, so the my AWS console or AWS server is preparing the image of that server too. Understood? So the difference between this is just the copy of our server 2, okay, which is in EC2. Okay, it is completely, we have deployed from the hardware level. This is just in copy. Okay, so the copy of my EC2 engine. Okay, so till then, this will take little time. So till then, let me try to change the name of this one to server 2 image one. Okay, image one, server 2 image one. Okay, hold on a second, it is pending. So if I want to perform any auto scaling, it should be, this data should be available. Then only I can perform it, okay? And one more thing, okay? Instances. Imagine that you have deleted that server 2. Instances, imagine that you have deleted server 2. So still using image copy of this server 2, that is nothing but the IAM image, you can access that server 2. Fine? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, server 2, you can access it. Okay, that is the possibility is there. Now, in the same, let us say you want to reconfigure. Imagine server 2, you have deleted. Again, you want that server 2 back. It's possible. So, we can reconfigure using the image copy of that server 2. Understood? That is also a possible here. Okay, so next is, let me check whether, yeah, now it is available. Now it is up and running. But the problem with this is, okay, so we have just created the image of the instance server 2. Okay, the instance of server 2 and server 2 and the image of that one, but we have not connected this to the machines. Okay, that we need to do using the auto scaling system. To do that one, okay, so some little configurations are required here. So what I will do, let's go to, okay, for the configuration, first what you need to do is, so we need to set the auto scaling config, the properties. Okay, we need to set the auto configuration properties. Go to launch configuration first. Go to launch configuration. Hit on launch configuration. Hold on. So here, why launch configuration? Yesterday, Srinivas sir was asking, sir, why we need a launch configuration? Can you briefly explain? See, if you take this two servers, say server one, okay, server one and image copy of, sorry, server two and the image copy of server two, what is the common over thing there? We are sharing the data, right? Data, sharing of the data is same, right? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sharing of the data is same. So in the same way, okay, so next is, I can in the same way, I have to configure my machine also. Okay, so since we are sharing the same data using the both server, similarly, it is also possible to configure the machine. In configuring the machine, what happens? Okay, so you can keep this front server is there, no, server two. Here I have mentioned 8 GB. So next to backend server, you can mention how much amount of the space and as well as the memory you want. Understood? There is no restrictions over there. Okay, so for auto config, why we are doing auto configuration is means, okay, so we have to configure both here. Okay, suppose if I want to configure data as well as the machine, okay, so we generally we go for launch configuration. Okay, so launch configuration, go to launch configuration, hit on launch configuration, hit on launch configuration. Hold on. Already I have created, this was for first server. Similarly, what I have to do here is create launch configuration. Let me create one new launch configuration here. Okay, so let the name be of my launch configuration, say server 2. Hold on. Yeah. Say server 2. Server 2. Image 1. Okay, image 1. Next is IAM. Go to IAM. So have a look on this. So IAM, as far as IAM, as I told you, configuration of CPU cycle, so we can configure. And other also we have other options also to configure here. There are many options. Okay, but what I will do, I'll use my image copy. Just now what I have created, which is that one? This one, right? Hello?
Yes, sir. Server 2 image 1.
Server 2 image 1. So I'll use the server 2 image. Understood? So that means my data, same data and the configuration also, just since we are doing the training purpose, so even the CPU cycle I'll keep the same here. Okay, so or else you can choose any one from here. CentOS, we have Laravel, we have, okay, there are many flavors of the operating systems are available. You can select as per your requirement. So in that case, what happened, your front EC server will be of one configuration and the other, the backend server will be of the other configuration. Understood? Suppose that I say in front end you want to display for, you want a server for web development. In the back end, let us imagine that you want the server for machine learning. Understood? So in that case, what I can do, in front end I can configure separately, back end my image copy I can configure separately here. Okay, so that is option is also offered by the Amazon. So here server, right now I'll take server 2 image 1. So that means I'm going to share the files, okay, that is index.html as well as server.html with these two servers now. Okay, there is server 2 as well as the image copy of the server 2. Okay, so AMI I have already selected. Choose the instance type, most important here is, okay, so it is also possible to choose the CPU cycles, how much amount of CPU cycles you want here. So it comes with the different categories, like how we have seen while deploying our EC2 engine. Similarly, here also, it comes with a lot of CPU cycles and the memory here. So for the instance of time, I'll go with the micro T2. Okay, T2 micro I'll take. Okay, so let me, yeah, T2 micro, that means I'm going to have my backend server also with the same configuration, CPU, okay, and the memory. Or else you can change here. If you want, you can change this also. Okay, so next to choose this one. So that means my instance type already I have selected. Now next is CloudWatch. Whether you want any log files, whether you want to check any log file, you can enable that also. Okay, so how many users are entering, how many users are accessing, okay, how much CPUs are utilized, all those can be configured. Even it is also possible to configure my the CloudWatch here. Understood? In the same way, EBS the one, this you, I'll keep this one, this entire set as optional. Storage volume, okay, so as far as storage volume is concerned, it is also possible. So how much amount of storage I want, I can use here. Okay, so next, add new volume, we can add the new volume for this. Okay, so next is this also I'll keep the same as it is. I don't want to change anything here. Okay, so next is creating the new security group. This is very important. So whenever you are creating any auto scaling or load balancing system, it is better to create a new security group. Auto scaling security group 3. I'll mention the same thing because 2 I'm using for previous one. Now 3 I will use for the this whatever right now what we are creating here. Okay, hope you are clear with this. Next, let's go to, okay, here, most important. Okay, even I want to access this, the backend, the image server using HTTP. So I'll add one more new rule here called HTTP. Okay, any doubt, ma'am?
No, sir. Actually, sir, when we selected the server 2 image 1, okay, so we had some other options also. So if we select something from that options, then is it necessary that we have to create our like EC2 instance separately?
No, ma'am. No, if you are selecting any other here from here, okay, so you need not to say, create a new EC2 engine over there. So that means whatever you are selecting, that will be attached with your the already created EC2 engine there. Understood?
Okay, okay.
So, okay, suppose I'm selecting Hive. Okay, Hive will be, okay, affecting, the Hive will be connected with your the main server, server 2 there. Understood? Understood?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now same thing, I'll server 2, image 1 I will create here. Okay, so next is regarding about, where I was here, right? Okay, so here I'll add one more new rule here. SSH already is there. So since I'm web-based server, so I'll use HTTP here. Okay, HTTP. So I'll select HTTP, TCP, 80 port, anywhere. Okay, anywhere. So next is, okay, key pair. Regarding about key pair, I'll use the existing key pair here. Or else, if you want, you can create the new key pair also. Okay, so I'll keep the same thing, key to badge 2 hyphen new. Acknowledge it. Okay, next, create, launch configuration. That means, now the configuration, launch configuration is over. Means, as far as EC, my EC2 engine is concerned, created. Hold on. Let me go to EC2 instance. Hold on. Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Yes, sir.
So now see what we have, I'm audible, right?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yeah. See here what I have done now in launch configuration. Okay, I have configured 2 machine now. Server 2 as well as my image. Okay, so let me go to here. Okay, so this 2, hold on. Okay, so have a look on this. So I have configured two machines now. One is server 2, okay, which is of 8 GB and some CPU cycles, okay, with Apache server. In the same way what I have done, okay, I have created one more called server 2, which is the image copy. Image copy in the sense, here also what I have done, I have Apache server and whatever I'm accessing from server 2, the same thing, even it is also possible to access from my image now. Cleared?
Hello? Yes, sir.
Understood, no? Okay, so now configuration of two machine is over. Now to use these two machines in load balancing, okay, so again I have to attach these two machine, nothing but the server 2 as well as the image copy with together. Understood, so that I can share the load balancing system. To do that, okay, so next what I have to do is, okay, I have to go for auto scaling. Okay, so I have to create one new auto scaling. So first what I did, okay, let me revise, okay, so that you should not be confused while configuring. Okay, I created EC2, next I configured, I installed Apache, next I created the image copy, that image copy is in IAM now. So after that what I did, okay, I configured, okay, the image copy of that which is in IAM using which one? Launch configuration. Understood. So now all the entire configuration of both the machine is over now. Now let's try to do auto scaling system. Okay, so to create the auto scaling system, first I have to create a auto scaling group. Have a look on this. Okay, first I have to create the auto scaling group. Why auto scaling group? Let us imagine that right now how many servers I have? Rutuja ma'am?
Two servers.
Let us imagine that again the number of users are increasing. Say today I had 100. After some time, let's say 15, after 15 days, it is increasing it to 200. Even in that case also, so it is not possible to handle by the two servers. So generally what we do, we try to add one more server, right? We try to create one more server, right? So to create, let us imagine, yes, creating the server remains the same. Okay, so we follow the same process. So after creating the third server, okay, generally what we do, we try to bring that third server in one group. Let us say what I will do, okay, that can be done by using auto scaling a group. Now what I will do for those two servers, no, I'll try to create the group. Okay, I'll try to bring those two servers in group. In future also, if I want to add more and more server, so I can add that more servers in auto scaling group here. So let's try to create the group. To create the group, what I will do, just hit on auto scaling group. Click on auto scaling group. Auto scaling group. Okay, here already I have created, okay, auto scaling group. That is for my two servers. Okay, so next, let's try to create one more auto scaling group here. Create auto scaling group. Next is auto scaling group name. Let's try to give the auto scaling group name be server two image 1, 1, 2, 3. I'll give 1, 2, 3. Just keep in mind this. Okay, sometimes I'll forget that. Okay, name of the auto scaling group is server 2 image 1, 2, 3. Now next to launch the template. So as far as template is concerned here, okay, so here just let me refresh. Template is nothing but the mirror copy what you have created. Okay, so mirror copy you have what you have created. Just hit on, let me hit on this. There is no template. Yeah, I'll come to this one template. Hold on. Okay, create template. But to create template, hold on. Let's go to create template. Yeah, go to create template. So here you will find that mirror copy of my server to machine. Okay, so I need to create one template here. Okay, so template is nothing but here, that mirror copy what I have created now, that same template I have to configure here. Okay, so here let me give the template name. Okay, so imagine the template name be say server 2. Okay, template I will write server 2 template. Okay, so next is template. Okay, can you see here? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is server 2 image 1. Just now what we have created, this I'm putting in description. Okay, so next is here the most important. Okay, that machine, EMI machine, what you have created, right? That you have to the call here. Okay, so here under EMI machine, say under EMI required, EMI machine. So you can see here. Okay, I have the template I can create here. So just now what I have created, same thing I will use here. Where is that? Quick custom. Hold on. Hold on. Here only, yesterday also I created, here only I was facing problem. So here, hold on, select template. Let me start with this. Are you confused? What I did? Okay, so auto scaling, I selected auto scaling, hold on. So after configuring, okay, I went to auto scaling, auto scaling group. Create one group for those two instances now. Here on, okay, so here hit on create group, auto scaling group. You give some name, say server 2 image 1, 2, 3. Okay, I'll give, just hit on next. Okay, hit on next. I'll just a template, we will try to select template in listener in the, hit on next. No, switch to launch configuration.
It is required.
It is required. To required. Hold on. Here. Hold on, ma'am. Here. Switch to launch configuration. Yes. Okay, let me give the name here. Yesterday also I committed mistake here only. Image 1, 2, 3. Okay, so next is switch to launch configuration. Hit on launch configuration. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So hit on switch to launch configuration. Okay, so switch to launch configuration here. Under launch configuration, you have that image. Can you see this? Hello? Yeah, server 2, image 1. Okay, this is the launch config, in launch configuration, what I have created. Okay, server 2, image 1, select this. Okay, so the moment when you select this, this is the configuration of the image machine. And this is the security group, T2 micro. Okay, so no key pair here, AMD machine. Next, hit on next. Click on next. Okay, so after that, this is very important step in the auto scaling systems. Here, VPC, by default, I'm using my default VPC here. So subnet masks, at least you have to choose 2 subnet masks here. Okay, so let me choose 1A. Okay, so minimum 2 subnet masks. So next is, I'll choose 1B. Okay, so I've chosen 2 now. Okay, 1A as well as 1B now. Understood. Now next is, after that, go to next, enable load balancing. Okay, select this is going to be an optional. Okay, I'll come to this one, application load balancer and classic load balancer later. Okay, when I'm setting the target group. Most important here is, okay, about the heartbeat, health checkup. Okay, so health checkup is nothing but, let's say, I want to check the status of the current status of both the machine. I'll set some threshold in the sense, let's say if the system is 70% is already consumed, say my main server, in my main server 70% of the CPU cycle is already consumed, means what I will do, I will instruct the load balancer to deploy one more new server. Hope you are cleared. Suppose that I say 70, it has raised to 72, after 1 second it has raised to say 75. So in that case, obviously I need the new machine, understood? So automatically the auto scaling load balancer should deploy that, understood? In the same way, imagine that, okay, the number of users are decreasing. Let's say the CPU cycle is around 60%. So in that case, what I will do, I'll try to keep the single machine. Hope you are clear. In this, we can check the status, health of the health of the our machines, understood? Every 30 seconds, it sends a log file to CloudWatch. Okay, or you can configure SNS also, simple, SES, that is simple email services. So you can send an email. So that means 70% of the CPU is already consumed, understood? So that can be checked here. So by default, I'll keep 30 seconds. 30 seconds is nothing but how many minutes? Around 5 minutes, right? Hello? Yeah, 5 minutes. So every 5 minutes, I'll try to check the health of my server here. Rest of the things are, I'll keep optional only. Monitoring, I don't want this. CloudWatch, again, you sending the log file to CloudWatch. Okay, if you are in analytics, if you are doing analytics, okay, in that case, CloudWatch is better, or else why to send the report here. Okay, so next is, hit on next. Your most important. Okay, hope everyone are listening. Participants, hello?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Yeah, see here. See, this is very important now. Someone yesterday asked me regarding about auto scaling. How many number of servers we required, sir? Yes or no? So have a look on this. That can be configured here. Group size. Desired capacity, see. Just to run one simple web servers, at least I need one server, no? Hello? Yes or no?
Yes,
just
sir.
To imagine web development you have. So at least I required one server. So that is the essential one. Now next, minimum capacity, I can keep one. Okay, minimum capacity of the server, always it should be one. So I can set the maximum capacity. Let us say I'll set the maximum capacity 5. So in that case, what happened? Our auto scaling system will be having the capacity to the deploy maximum up to 5 servers. Hope you are cleared. Maximum up to 5 servers means in total, how many servers will be there? Tell me. Total at maximum, okay, usage, let us say every second around 50,000 users are visiting your site. So that means in that case, what happened? How many servers will be engaging those 50,000 users per second? In this
the
case,
max will be 5.
Max will be, no? Yeah,
five.
Five servers will be engaging all the 50,000 users per second here. Understood? So it is up to you how much you want to deploy it. Understood? So it is, this is, I'm designing this one for training purpose. I'll keep.
Sir, is there any limit to it?
There is no limit. There is no limit here. Even you can have up to 100 also. Okay, or 100 also. But while setting the maximum and minimum server capacity, I think it's better to predict how many users visit your site. That it is possible to predict. So let's say the new site means very few users will be there. Next, after some times, if it is hitting in market, let us say it is clicking in market, your site is clicking in market, means obviously the number of users are using. So you can analyze that one. If the load is decreasing, if it is taking, if your site is taking a lot of time to open, means again, it's better to implement load balancer there. Hope you are cleared.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so yes, sir. I think it's GT Matrix. There is one site called GT Matrix. In GT Matrix, you can check how many numbers are visiting, or else you can implement Google Data Analytics. One tool is there. Okay, in Google Data Analytics tool, you can track each and everything. Okay, which users are visiting which page? Okay, which, how many users are more interested on which page? Okay, so based upon that one, you can set your the load balancing systems here. Okay, so next is target. This is also very important. Okay, scaling policy. Okay, this is about the number of servers here. Remember, number of servers. Next, we have scaling policy here. Okay, just for the demonstration, I'll use this. is a scaling policy name. Okay, so you can give any name here. Okay, so there is no restriction. Now, how you want to scale your load balancing? Whether you want to scale the load balancing based upon the CPU, or you want to balance using the network. Understood? The network is recently we have done. Okay, so CPU cycle. So CPU cycle you can set here. Target value is nothing but your threshold here. Let's say I'm setting here 80. 80 is my threshold. Means when one server is reaching 80, okay, so that means I have to switch to second server. Hope you are cleared. Participants. Yes, suppose that a user are visiting, 80% CPU cycle is already in utilized. Again, the number of users are increasing. 81 it has reached. At that time, I have to send the instruction to the load balancer. That means you launch one more. In the same way, in target value, what happened? Okay, if the value, threshold value is decreasing, let us say from 80% to it has came down to 79%. So in the same way, I have to reduce one server. Instead of using two server, I will use one server. Cleared? Hello?
Yes.
Okay, so now here also heartbeat messages. So we can set the heartbeat messages instance need. Second warm up before including in the matrix. So you can set 2 seconds. Let's say, imagine before deploying, let us say 80 is the threshold. I want to deploy one more server when it is heading towards 81. So before deploying one more server, I can set the instance need or the seconds here. Let's say before deploying, when that is it has reached 80, okay, before deploying the new server, I'll wait for 20 seconds. Cleared? Okay, I'll wait for 20 seconds. If in within that period, 20 seconds, if it is reaching, if still that my threshold is 81, let's say greater than 80, so at that time I will deploy, because the network, no, the number of users, how you are visiting, it's keep on spiking. Okay, every seconds the number of users will increase, every second the number of users will decrease. So that's the reason I'll try to have the range here. 20 seconds is of my range. When 80% is at threshold, I'll wait for 20 seconds. If it is increasing, if it is still greater than 80, after 20 seconds, I will launch new server. If it is still, okay, lesser than, if it lesser, let us imagine that it has came down to, okay, some 79.99%, I will not launch the a new server. Okay, that can be done using instance need second. You can set here how much you want. Either you can give in minutes or you can give in seconds. Better to give in seconds. I think what I feel, it is better to give around 1 minute, 60 seconds. Wait for 60 seconds. If the traffic is spiking up and down, okay, so let the system itself will decide whether to deploy the new machine or not here. Okay, so next is rest of the things. Scaling protections, I'll keep this one as optional. I don't want to instance scaling in the protection option. That is related to your VPC. If you have custom VPC, we can configure this. So next is hit on next. Okay, so here next comes the notification. If you want to send any notification through email, okay, so I can make use of SES service here. Sorry, SNS server, or send notification message using SES server. If you want, you can add this also, or else you can keep this one as an optional. Next, related to tags, I'll keep as it is. I don't want tags here. So next, this is the review. Just try to have the review of my auto scaling property. So default to submit marks I have taken. Next, load balancing. Okay, so load balancing, okay, configuration, advanced EC2, 30 seconds, the heartbeat message I have taken here. Okay, monitoring disabled. That means I'm not sending any file to CloudWatch. Minimum, maximum servers. Okay, size, next to the policies. Everything is configured nicely here. Okay, so rest of the rest add notification. So I have kept as an optional. Tags also I have kept as an optional. Now next is create auto scaling. But in the company is what happened. So you have to configure those based upon the requirements. If the manager says, you know, configure it. Okay. So next is server 2 image 123 is my new server, right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Server 2 image 123 is my new auto scaling now. Okay. Auto scale the property here. Understood. So it is successfully completed. I have completed successfully now. Now next, still there are some more what I can say. The configurations are required. If I'll go to PPT now, you will understand. Okay, how much work we have completed here so far. I'll go to PPT. Okay, let's go to PPT. Say, hope you can see the PPT. Hello?
Yes.
In PPT, what I have done? Say, this is server 2. Middle one is the server 2. Okay, so I have created one image called server 2 image 123. Understood? I have set the threshold also. What is my threshold? Hello?
5 servers.
No, 80% is my threshold, no?
No, 80%.
Yeah, 80% is a threshold. If the, okay, the number of users are increasing here. Okay, so let's say 81%. So what I will do along with these two server, I will deploy one more server here. Hope you are clear. Understood?
Yes, sir.
If the threshold is decreasing, let's say, this is having 82%. This is having, let's say, around... what I can say, okay, 82% here also, again, I will deploy the new server. In the same way, if the network is spiking down, what I will do, I'll reduce it. Let's say this is having around 80%, this is having 79%. Okay, already third server will be there. So I will remove this one from my network. Removing is nothing but I'm not going to use this server. Okay, that means this server will not be under utilization. This is how. So far till auto scaling, so we have configured this much. Only this much we have configured. Two servers we have configured. Now both this server can communicate with each other. In case if the threshold is increasing, I can deploy the third server also. Now next is, okay, so user should be able to interact with this server, right? Yes or no, participants?
Yes, sir.
So user should be able to interact this server. Understood? Then only they can access our information. To do that one, what we generally we do, we use another service called a load balancer. Okay, so the main task of the load balancer is what it will allow the user to interact with our server. Okay, but here in load balancer, what happened? Okay, before accessing our server, okay, so it tried to route the number of users. Let us say this server is free. So what the load balancer will does, so it will try to route some of the user to this server, some of the user to this server, some of the user to this server, so that I can keep the performance of the system, okay, the same here. Understood? So this is the main job of the load balancer or elastic load balancer. Now next is, okay, so when we have load balancer, there are three types of load balancer, okay, as far as AWS is concerned. First is called classic load balancer. Next we have application load balancer. Yesterday I was explaining this. Classic, no one is using now in nowadays classic, because it will equally distribute, okay, the load balancing. But in the application load balancer, based upon the application or the page, you can migrate or you can deviate the what I can say, the users. Okay, so here in this our demo, I have taken one is, I think, index page. The another one is server one, right? server1.html. Okay, so I can migrate that one using application load balancer. Okay, let's try to have enough talking. Let's go to session, hands-on session. Now, right now, I am in where auto scaling, right? So after configuration of the auto scaling, next comes the load balancing. Okay, now let's go to load balancing. Let me open this
The console isn't visible.
Console is not well visible. Okay, now is it possible? You can see, right, the console. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so right now I'm in auto scaling group. Already auto scaling is done now. Now let's load balancing. Load balancing, you can see all those options are available in EC2 only. Okay, so you need not to go for other services. Load balancer. Okay, hit on load balancer. Okay, click on load balancer. Load balancer is nothing but a proxy. How proxy works in network, in the same way load balancer will work, okay, in Amazon web server. Hold on. Fine. So here, have a look on this. Already I have created two. This is for my project one. Project one, I have one client. So this is for demonstration I am using. Okay, so next let's try to create one load balancer here. Hit on load balancer. Here, as I said, there are three types here. Classic load balancer. You can have classic load balancer also. Application load balancer, network load balancer. This is recently they have introduced a network load balancer. So right now I'll use application load balancer. Okay, so let's go to hit on application load balancer. Here, okay, so you need to give the name of the load balancer. Let's say the load balancer name be server 2 load balancer. Okay, load balancer, server 2 load balancer. Internet facing, there are two options here, internet facing and internal. Internet facing is for external world outside of the company. Let's say web through, let's say public is accessing your information. Okay, so suppose if you want to have the load balancing in that environment, we can have internet facing. Internal load balancing, in internal load balancing what happened within the company. Okay, within the company, if the information you are sharing using the IP addresses, so there also we can establish the load balancing. So since Apache, I'm going to have the load balancing for my website, I'll use internet facing. IPv4 type, IP, I'll keep as it is IPv4 only. So here along with this one, since it is HTTP based, so already HTTP is already there. HTTP my 80 port, that means I'm going to internal facing load balancer, I'm going to access through this protocol, HTTP, okay, hyper transfer, text transfer protocol. So next, availability zone. Here, as again, I'm saying availability zone. Okay, so whatever the subnet you have chosen, same subnet, you also try to choose here also. VPC is default here. Okay, apt, this is what subnet I have chosen. Okay, in the same way, I have chosen 1B also. Both you choose here. Add-on services, I'm not interested in add-on services here. Okay, so if you want, you can have a static IP addresses. If you want the static IP addresses, so you can have it. Okay, so next, configuration. Okay, configuration and security. Hit on configuration and security. Here, the most important, I think it's better to create a new security here. Okay, better to use this new security group. Okay, for auto scaling system. I'll create one new security group for my load balancing. Say my security group be, let's say server 2 load balancing. Okay, load balancing. Okay, load balancing. Next is rules here. Already custom TCP is there. Add rule. Next to HTTP. HTTP. HTTP TCP. Next. Okay, let me set this one anywhere. Custom TCP, HTTP I have, I think that is enough, I guess. Load balancing, most important here, create a new security group here, load balancing. Next is target group. Next comes the target group. Okay, so in target group, generally what we do, we try to, which page, suppose let us imagine that, okay, I have a server, have a look on this. Participants, hello?
Yes, sir.
Have a look on this, this is very important. In target group, generally what we do, we try to migrate the the users. Suppose again, I'll go to PPT. PPT, have a look on my application, have a look on my application load balancer. So I have two files over there, right? Yes or no, Rutuja ma'am? Hello?
Yes, sir.
One is html.index, right?
Yeah.
Another one is a server2.index. Okay, I have two files there. Imagine, okay, so those who are looking for html.index, I want to migrate them to this server, server 2. Cleared? Similarly, those who are looking for my server2.index file, sorry, server2.html file, I will migrate them to this server. Means, concept is simple. Okay, if the people are looking for my main page index.html, they are going to use my server 2 account or server 2. And the people who are going to searching for the server 2 dot HTML page, I'm going to migrate them to where my mirror copy of server 2. Okay, hope you are cleared. And that can be done using load balancing. Understood? Same thing. If you take in real time scenario, let us imagine that you have one in websites. Okay, you have one the complete one server for to handle front end data or front end work. Okay, and in the back end, let us imagine that you have another area called machine learning. So you want to handle people accessing of machine learning. That is the other department. So I can migrate that one. The people who are looking for your main pages, web pages, you can migrate using this load balancer, load one. Similarly, I can migrate those who are looking for machine learning using load two here. Okay, see, this is comes under application. That will be taken care by whom? The load balancer system. Understood? Again, it will check for the capacity. This clusters, no, this servers, it keeps on sending the heartbeat message. So let's say my threshold is 80. I have reached 80%. It keeps on sending the load balancer. Okay, so based upon that one, what happened? Load balancer will decide. Let's say 60%. Okay, it is occupied. Understood? Again, he can migrate some of more users to this server. Similarly here also. Okay, this is how load balancing work here. Now let's go to, again, I'll go to my the main page. I'll go to my main page where I was. I think I was in target, no? Yeah. Hello? Hello, participant?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I was creating target group, no? Configure. Let's try to. That can be done. Okay. So that migration can be done using the target group here. Okay. So let's try to create the target group. Let me try to create the new target group. Let's say server two, next IP address lambda function or instance. I want to do it for instances here. Okay, and what is the source here? Protocol HTTP. Okay, 80 port. Through 80 port, they are going to use it. Health check. Okay, HTTP only. I'm going to have advanced health check. I don't want to do this. I don't want to configure this. Okay, because this is related. Already we have configured. See, healthy threshold 5 max. Okay, so healthy threshold by default it has taken. Okay, timeout 5 seconds. Interval 30 seconds. Successful code is 200 here. Okay, so next register target. Okay, so register target here. So here in register target here, yeah. So you can see here, these are my number of what the instances. Okay, so in this instance, I'm going to deploy the target group. Nothing but the server which is in the background of my user. Okay, so next is hit on. Don't do anything here. Just keep as it is. Automatically it will take. Okay, register target. Next is hit on review. Create it. Okay, so here authorized to security group. Appear multiple times. The same permission is not authorized. One second. Failed to create load balancer. Failed to create load balancer. The permission must not appear multiple times. Review and resolve. Let me check. What is that? Security group, no? Load balancing. Let me check the security group. Yeah, this is edit. Let me edit here. Hold on. Load balancing. I think the same. Yeah, here. Have a look on this. HTTP. Two times I have given, no? That's the reason it was not accepting. So let me close. Okay, let me delete one. Configure routing. Okay, target group already. Just remember this name. Just to remind, I'll use target group. Target group. Next is. Okay, next register target. Next is. Okay, review. Okay, just review and create it. So that means now. My target group is, now I have created the target group. Now target group is created. Now I have to configure this target group to my auto scaling. Hope you are clear. Say, are you confused, participants? Hello, any doubt?
Not yet, sir.
Not yet? So you cleared with target group?
Yes, sir.
You are cleared with what I did now? Using target group, I'm just migrating using the load balancer. Okay, I have created the target group just to migrate my queries from the user. Understood. Now, those query should go to where? Hello? Those query should go to, I have to forward those queries where? On my server, no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I have to forward those queries to my server. Understood. Now server, I have two servers. Okay, server 2 and image copy of the server 2. Understood. And I have merged both the server using auto scaling system. Understood. So that means both the servers are in auto scaling system. Next, what I have to do, okay, that auto scaling system, let go to merge this target group on auto scaling system. So what I have to do is, hold on. Go to target groups. Okay, I have to merge this target group now. Go to target group. Screen is not visible. Hold on. Go to target group. So I have to link this server to load balancer to my auto scaling group now. Go to target groups. Where it is? Target groups. Go to target groups. Okay, so select the load balancer. Which is the load balancer just now I have created? Target group 2. Not. Select this. Okay, select this target group. Sorry, target group just now what I have created, right? Server 2. Select this. After selecting this, hold on, not here. Select this target group. So after selecting the target group, go to load balancer. Hold on. I'm confused here. After selecting the target group, select the target group. This is my target group now. Server 2 target group. Next is go to load balancer. Go to load balancer. Under load balancer, see, this is active now. Which is the load balancer I have created? Server 2, right? Server 2 load balancer. Yeah, select this server 2 load balancer. So under this, go to auto scaling group. Hold on. Let me check here. Auto scaling group. One second. Hold on. Hold on. Here auto scaling group. Here I'm missing somewhere. Load balancer. Security group. One second, guys. One second. Target with auto scaling. Go to target group. Here I have some target groups. Select the target groups. This is my target group. Let me check here. Select the target group. Here I'm committing mistake. Here health checkup is okay. Okay, load balancing round robin fashion. So here, not here. Go to load balancer. Hold on, participants. Here, somewhere I'm committing mistake here. Configure target. Go to target. This is the target group. This is a target group. Under target group, select the target group. Let's go to auto scaling. Yeah, auto scaling group here, not load balancer. Auto scaling group. Sorry. Go to auto scaling group. Okay. Sorry, not load balancer. So I have to go to auto scaling groups. Okay, auto scaling groups. Here, this is a server, right? Hello.
Yes, sir.
This is a server. So this is just now what the server I have created under auto scaling. So here I have to mount my target group. Okay, so to mount the target group, go to details. Under details, there is an option called launch configuration. Here, purchase option instance. Okay, load balancing. Can you see this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, under okay, so don't get confused. This is even I got confused. Under auto scaling, after creating the target group, okay, go to auto scaling. Under auto scaling, select your load balancing. Okay, so under load balancer, okay, since I have created this just now, I have created this load balancer. Under that, okay, so under edit option, there is an option called load balancing. Edit this. Okay, edit this here. Okay, so we have to give okay the load balancer, the target, sorry, target group for the load balancer. What is the target group for the load balancer here? Which one I have used? Hello?
A target group.
Target group, server to target group. Okay, so this is just now what I have created. So this I have configured. That means load balancer, so based upon the queries of the user, it try to deviate. Okay, so how we have configured in target group, so based upon that one, the load balancer will try to deviate the users, so either to server 1 or server 2. Okay, so here load balancer already have created. This option is for, remember, this option is for classic load balancer. Okay, so we are not going to use any if it is an application load balancer, we are not going to use anything here. Understood? If you are using classic load balancer, then we have to give the classic load balancer here. Okay, so next is update this. Okay, update this. So after updating, okay, it will take little time, hold down. Okay, so now you can see that I have configured my target group to this auto scaling load balancer. So let me check. Okay, so you can see here my target group is, okay, so now I have configured this. Now next is, okay, again I have to go to listener. Okay, so in listener I can select, since I have two pages here, so I don't have the multiple servers. Okay, so we'll try to deviate our two pages now. Okay, so to deviate two pages, again you select the same server to image 23. Next is go to listener. There is an option here, hold on. Okay, now next is, okay, I want to deviate this. To deviate, say, have a look on this. Let's go to server. Okay, this, can you see my screen? Which screen you can see, participants?
Browser.
See, have a look on this. The moment when I'm clicking this IP address, no, this page is from server 2. Again, have a look on this. Okay, I have two pages here. Say server2.html. Understood? Server2.html, though two pages are there. So what I will do, if the users are clicking, say, if the users are hitting this, so I will migrate them to the one server, my main server, server 2. If the users are interested in this page, HTML, sorry, server2.html. So what I will do, I will migrate them to some, which one? My mirror server. Cleared?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, so mirror server. Okay, so to do that one, okay, well, again we need some little configuration here. Okay, so go to what is that? Load balancer. Now you go to load balancer. Okay, load balancer. Okay, load balancer will decide that, but load balancer will decide based upon the target group what you have mentioned there. Okay, so next go to load balancer. Click on load balancer. Hit on load balancer. Wait, hold on a second. hold on participants. So yeah, these are my load balancer. Now which one I have to select? Pooja ma'am, Rutuja ma'am, hello, which is my new load balancer? Hello,
server 2, I guess.
Server 2, yeah, server 2 load balancer. Just know what I have created. Server 2, select to load balancer, server 2 load balancer. Okay, so now next let's try to deviate the pages. To deviate the pages, there is an option called here. Have a look on this listener. Hit on listener. Under listener, okay, there is an option called, have a look on this. So now what was happening? Okay, even if you set no server 2 load balancer, okay, so everything was okay. The load balancer used to check the availability of the server. Let's say server 1 is free. Okay, so if the users are clicking, let's say the users are typing like this. Okay, users are typing like this. So it used to send the load balancer used to send this all the user to this server. Understood? That is 94.71. In the same way, let's say even if the users are eating like this, say let's the users are interested in this page. So in that case also, the server was, sorry, the load balancer was utilizing my server 1. Understood? Now I don't want to do that one. Okay, so imagine that n number of servers users are coming in. Understood? So I want to deviate now. By manually I want to deviate that one. So that can be done. Let's say what I will do. Imagine if the users are coming to this site. Okay, so I will give separate server to them. Okay, and if the users are coming to this site, I'll assign the separate server to them. Hope you are clear. Okay, so to do that, again you go to load balancer, select your load balancer. Okay, so next go to edit. Okay, hit on edit. Hit on edit. Here, see, already by default some of the pages are already configured by the Amazon. Okay, so now if I want to do that, if I want to set up in that way, so what I can do is hit on plus symbol. Okay, hit on plus symbol so that it will allow us to insert, or I can deviate my pages or the users based upon the pages or the request. Here there is a rule called if else rules. If then rules generally we use here. Say in, now I will set one strategy here. Say if the page is, let's say the path. Okay, if the path is, say the path is this one. Hope you are cleared. After slash, okay, after slash server 2. Okay, participants, hello?
Yes.
After slash, okay, by default, see, by default index.html, which is nothing, which is in my 94.71. Okay, so I will use my main server. If the path is this slash server 2.html, okay, let me check. I will set that. If the path is that one, let's say if the path is this, okay, I'll copy here, or else you can use asterisk symbol also, server asterisk, you can put server. So whatever comes with the server, okay, the pages or the directory, all those should be redirected to some other servers. Then, okay, I'll have the forward to, there is an option here, redirect to, forward to, and return fixed response. Okay, forward to, hit on forward to. Where I want to forward this, tell me where I have to forward.
To the image of server 1.
Server 1, understood. This image of the server 1, I will forward this. Okay, image of the server 1, I'll forward this to there. Next is, it's very simple, but you need to understand that, okay, how the things are taking here. No, server 1, no, not server 1. So I have to set the target group here. Which is the target group? Just now what I have created. Server 1, image 1 was my previous one, previous demo. I have to migrate to which one? Server 2, target group. Okay, this option I have to select. Understood? Server 2, target 2. Okay, so next is, here, save this. Save this. Okay, it is already saved now. Now almost our job is over. Okay, so now next is have a look on this. Okay, so let me go to EC2 now. I'll go to EC2. Where is my EC2? EC2. Hold on. So can you see here? Server 1 was created, right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Server 1 was created. Server 1 I created. Okay, the moment when I did auto scaling, okay, the mirror copy of that one, server 1 is already created. Now you can see here. Utojaman, before it was not able to see, right?
Yes.
Hello? Before it was not able to see, now you can see. This is the image copy of my server 2. Okay, so image server 2 I will write. Server 2, okay, plus it, understood. So that means we'll check now whether it works or not. First, let's try to have server 2. We will check whether the my Apache files are working in the server 2 or not. Okay, let me copy the IP address. Next, paste it over here. Okay, so this is from server 2, right? Okay, so next is, again I'll go to EC2. Let me close this is over. Okay, again I'll go to EC2. This is my server 2 now, understood? Server 2. Okay, server 2. Next is, copy this one. You can differentiate. See, my IP, public IP addresses are different here. Okay, so let me check here. Again I will run this. Okay, and hit okay. Can you see? Hello?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Can you see? This is from server 1. Server 1, okay. If suppose, let us say, imagine that users are coming in. Understood. Users are coming in to your site. Let's say this site. Okay, so next, either I can assign this server, server 1, or I can migrate the user to this image copy of the server, or I can migrate the user to this server 2, actual server, understood? But in both the server, user are going to access the same. That if you want to check that effect, okay, so again, what I will do, I'll go to load balancer now. Okay, go to load balancer. So that can be done here by manually I'm doing here. So that means here, if I want to open this page, I'm using this IP address. If I want to open this page, I'm using this IP address. If I want to do automatically load, let the load balancer will decide. Okay, so that can be done. Okay, go to load balancer. Okay, here there is an option called load balancer. Okay, have a look on this. This is the newly created load balancer, right? Participants.
Hello? Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
have sir. A look on this. So what I will do, this load balancer is having, I have merged, okay, both this server, server 1 and server 2, image copy of server 2 and image copy of server 2 in load balancer. Now what I will do, let me select this load balancer, and this is the endpoint here, DNS. Okay, I'll copy this DNS. Okay, so next, go to copy that one. Can you see? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this page is from server 2. Okay, and the load balancer itself will decide. Understood? How to redirect. Okay, the user. If I'm up now, right now, I'm accessing this index.page, no? index.page, right? index.page. So that means load balancing, load balancer is migrating me, or load balancing is deviating me to use which server? Hello. If I'm accessing this page, means which server I'm using? This or this? Let me go to EC2. Okay, I'll go here. I'll go here, instances. Tell me which server I'm using. Right now I'm using accessing this page. Which server I'm using? Yes. Tell me.
So the second server.
No. In target group, what I did? In target group, if it is an index page, okay, if the people are visiting in index page, so what I have done there, I've configured for my basic server, right? This server. If it is in this page, no. If the users are visiting to this index page, so that means the load balancer will migrate those users to this server, server one. Hope you are understanding.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If the let's imagine that. Okay. So what I will do? I'll try to access now. What is that? Server two. Server2.html. Now, can you see my page has changed, right? Hello.
Yes,
sir. Yes.
The page has changed. So if the users are requesting this page, okay, the any page after slash server2.html, any page after after this path, the path after this IP address, that is slash server2.html. So in that case, what I am doing in target function, I'm migrating those user to use
the image
copy of my server to. Understood?
Yes.
Sorry.
Sir.
Yeah. Migrating those users to use the image copy of that server to. Understood. Hope you are clear with this. Let me check that whether I'm possible to access that one or not. This page is from server two now. Okay. So this is from through the load balancer, and load balancer using my server two it is using. Let me check again. It is not possible through here, I guess. So again, I have to check here. Suppose let us say, okay, server two. Okay, I'll go to EC2. Okay, server two. Let me take server two. Let me copy this IP address of server two. Let me paste it over here. Okay, so what you can see here, this page is from server two, right?
Yes.
Now, what again you see the effect you can see here. What I will do, 13.223.94.71/server2.html. Now tell me which server it is using. Which server I'm using?
The same server, I guess.
No.
Sir, the image copy.
Image copy again. Of a?
Server 2.
Server 2. Hope you are cleared. You want me to repeat?
Yes, sir.
See, okay. So in target group, what I did? Okay. In target group, let me go to target group. You will understand. Where is my target group? Target groups. Let me open this. Hold on. Okay, so this is my target group now. I will look on this. This is my target group. Let me my target group. Okay, so this is my target group. So here target group, target, not target group, where I have configured that? Can someone tell me where I have configured a target group? This section generally we use to configure, but we can redirect this path using auto scaling group. Go to auto scaling. Hold on. Have a look on this server 2, just now what I have created. Okay, server 2. Not this. Sorry, not in auto scaling, load balancer. Sorry, load balancer. Always I get confused. Load balancer. Hold on. Okay, so this I think this is my load balancer, server 2 load balancer. Go to listener. In listener, hit on view and edit rules. Here, have a look on this. Can you see this, participants?
Yes, sir.
Have a look on this.
Yes, sir.
After slash. Okay, so after slash. After slash. Okay, so let me edit this. See, after slash. Slash means what? This IP address. Okay. Till here, understood? Till yes, here, if the users are visiting, till here means nothing but my index page. Okay, so by default, I will assign them which server?
Server 2, the regular one.
Yeah, the regular one. Server 2, I will assign them. Understood?
Yes,
if, let's say, if after slash server 2, let us imagine that I have n number of the pages after slash, say slash server2.html. I have just created server2.html. So if this is a page, or I can mention here server, okay, server 2, let's say, server asterisk also I can mention here. Like this also it is possible. That means all the pages or the folders which starts from server, okay, so all those pages should be redirected to my image server.
Image.
Understood. So here, yes, in this case, what I have done, server2.html, since I have only one page. If someone is visiting this page, okay, I have to redirect them to my image copy. Understood. Let me update this. Okay, so I cannot update, I guess. Let me cancel this. So that means if anyone is using this, if anyone is using trying to access this page, that should be they are accessing through server 1. Now again I'll go to here. Okay, let me copy. Now see, you can see the difference here. What happens, I'll go to EC2. Again I'll go to EC2 here. Instance. I'll go to EC2 instance. Server 2, no? Right? I'll copy the IP address of server 2. Okay, I'll copy the IP address of server 2, paste it. Okay, so next slash, the moment when I hit slash server 2, okay, so you will be redirected. You can see this page now. You can see this page, right? But where this is executing? Hello?
Sir, into the image file of server.
Image file of server, but have a look on this. IP is remaining same, no?
Yes, sir.
IP is remaining same. IP is same.
Yes, sir.
Understood. IP is same, but okay, I have migrated everything. All the process is taking place on the image server. Hope you are cleared with
yes,
this
sir.
Is how we are working with the load balancing. Now next, maybe if you are confused, generally what we do, we try to convert this IP address to domain name. Understood? Domain name. Let us say xyz.com/ okay, server2.html. xyz.com is executing in server 1. Okay, slash server2.html will be executing in the mirror copy of the image.
Circle one.
Hope you are cleared.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is how load balancing. Remember, it's very important because see, the companies, almost all the companies are planning to sell their product online. They don't want to leave any area wherever. Okay, selling options are there. They are trying it. And I think it's online selling is the best one. If the website is clicked, you know, okay, so that means number of users are more number of users will come. Okay, obviously company will generate a huge amount of money. There is no doubt about that. Okay, but when the number of users are coming, load in the system, the website will get increased. In that case, I'm 100% sure that whatever the control panel you are using, whatever the local service providers are offering, that is not going to work out. Understood? You cannot handle such a huge load using those simple control panels. We must migrate towards the cloud computing system, or the system where you have load balancing options. Understood? So that, okay, there should not be any problem while accessing the pages in the front end, because the customer, they don't care. Okay, what you're doing in the back end, they want the availability of the data. Understood? Even let's say the customer is trying to share their the bank details. Understood? If they feel like 3 seconds delay, 4 seconds delay, they try to hesitate to share their bank details. So we should take utmost care. Okay, when we talk about the performance, and thanks to Amazon is giving one of the best platform. Okay, to divide the load. When the number of users are increasing in the website or any other system. Hope you are cleared with this. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Okay, or else we'll continue in the next session. Next session will be for data migration. Okay, so let's try to discuss about the data migration in next session. Any doubt, ma'am? Hello?
No, sir, no doubt.
You practice this, remember. I have struggled a lot. I have practiced, not struggling. I practice a lot. Okay, load balancing. I think we have to configure in 4 to 5 areas, sub areas. Okay, so that practice only you can, you will get the confidence only through practice. Okay, theory, it is not going to work in load balancing system. Srinivas sir, you also try to practice this. Okay, you were not present in the half an hour session, I guess.
Yes, actually I had an important practical today.
Okay.
In my college, so I was attending that.
Fine, no problem. I'll upload this recording session. Okay, maybe okay, after sir. Some time. Okay, have a nice day. Thank you,
sir.
Yes, sir.